Oh, I almost had it. Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video in my full month of nothing new. I have such an exciting video for you guys today for two reasons. Number one, we're talking about eyeshadow palettes. But more importantly, this video is in collaboration with two of my favorite people here on YouTube, Jen Phelps and Andrea Mottigliano. I have been a longtime fan of both Jen and Andrea's channels. I absolutely love them. They share my affinity for eyeshadow palettes. They love reviewing and trying out different palettes. They talk a lot about affordable palettes on their channels. And they also both have this incredible talent for swatching shadows on camera. I know that sounds like kind of a silly thing, but trust me, as a creator, it's not that easy to do. And who doesn't love a good eyeshadow swatch? So a big thank you to both of them for collaborating with me in today's video, in which we will be talking about five eyeshadow palettes that I like, that are good, but I think could be even better. I'm sure we all can relate to having an eyeshadow palette that we really like, but maybe it's missing something, or maybe there's a shade or two that we just don't get any use out of. So I will be sharing with you guys five of mine and what I would do to change them to make them perfect for me. Of course, I will link Jen and Andrea's videos down below. I cannot wait to hear their thoughts, what they end up selecting. Be sure to head over to their channels and check those out. And of course, if you are not yet subscribed to their channels, which I'm sure many of you are, be sure to subscribe and let them know I sent you. Trust me, you guys will absolutely love them both. Before we get into the palettes that I picked, special welcome to those of you that are new to my channel, especially those of you visiting from Jen or Andrea's. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and of course, if you do, be sure to subscribe before you leave, ring that notification bell if you'd like to be notified when I upload a new video. And with that out of the way, let's get right into the palettes. So it was very easy for me to come up with these five palettes, because there are five very specific palettes. Actually, I could probably think of a couple more, but these are the ones that were at the top of my list, the ones that I knew I love that palette, but there is just something about it that I really don't like. These are in no particular order, but the first one I'm going to mention is the Sweet Talk palette by ColourPop. Perhaps one of the most beautifully packaged palettes that ColourPop has ever come out with. I love the packaging of this. And the color story inside is stunning. There are many people I have heard tout this as one of their favorite ColourPop palettes, and I can totally see why. But my simple reason for picking this palette is the pressed glitters inside here. I believe this might have been one of the first palettes that ColourPop put pressed glitters in, and I don't know that I thoroughly researched before, really even understood my own thoughts behind pressed glitters. I just don't really like them that much. I don't use them very much. While I do think they can be beautiful, especially on camera, in my everyday life, if I was wearing a very thick and chunky glitter like these two, which both very much are, let me just kind of swatch them. I'm not sure that you guys can even on camera tell how chunky the glitter particles are. But if I have chunky glitters like this on my lids in my everyday life, and I am a mom of four kids, so my everyday life consists of going to the grocery store, dropping kids off at carpool, or at least it did back in the day, man. But I have this kind of insecurity. If I have a glitter this chunky on my lids and I'm having maybe a conversation with someone, I feel like they might be questioning why I got into my daughter's craft supplies and put them on my eyes. And I know that's a little silly, and I know there are people out there that absolutely love glitters. I think there is nothing wrong with that. But personally for me, they're just a little bit too glitzy, too glamorous, too blingy for my makeup style. That said, I do think the colors of these two shades are beautiful. So here's what I would love to see happen with this palette. For the shade Prima Drama, which is this kind of multi-colored glitter, I would love to see a duochrome here. I don't know that I've seen a lot of duochromes from ColourPop. It doesn't seem like they do duochromes all that often, but I would love it if this shade was more of a traditional shimmery duochrome than a glitter. I think that would be stunning. I think it would add a lot of interest to the looks that you could get out of this palette, but it would still give you some dimension. As for this gold glitter right here, Early Morning, this is also a beautiful color. I would love to see this in the same color, but just in a traditional foiled or shimmery formula. I actually even went through my other ColourPop palettes. I think I have about 12 of them, and I couldn't find a duplicate for this shade in a traditional shimmer formula. So I think having that in here would be absolutely amazing. Again, I wouldn't change the color story of this. I just, as someone that's not a fan of glitters, every time I open this palette, I can't help but think of what this palette could have been, at least for me. So those are the two things I would change about the Sweet Talk palette. I honestly think if those two changes were made, this would be such a perfect palette for me. I would love it and use it so much more than I actually do. The next palette I would love to see some changes made to, a palette from Juvia's Place. This is the Saharan palette. This is probably one of their more underrated palettes. I think it's also one of their older palettes. It's been around for quite a while, and I love this color story. I think it's one of their most underrated palettes, but there is a couple of major flaws with this one for me personally. The biggest one being the shade right here. I am not a big fan of matte black eyeshadows. I just don't get a lot of use out of them. I much prefer a deep, rich, chocolatey brown to smoke out my outer corner, to put in my outer V, or even to use as kind of like a smudgy liner at times. I often find blacks to be a little bit more difficult to work with. They can sometimes be a little bit tricky to blend, and often when you do blend them, they blend out into this very charcoaly gray kind of look that I just am not a big fan of. Let me just swatch this black for you guys. It is a beautiful, very rich, very pigmented black, and I know a lot of people do use a matte black very regularly, so I certainly don't speak for everyone. I like a brown because I feel like it's just a little bit softer. And in addition to that, I just think a matte brown would go a little bit better with this whole very fall-inspired color story. Now that would be the first and the most crucial change I would make in this palette, but since we're changing things around a little bit, there are a couple things that I think could be changed in here to make it even a little bit better. So I do really like this corner coral shade right here, the color Sokoto. It is very bold, it is very bright and vivid and intense, and as much as I think it's beautiful to swatch and look at, I don't use it very often, so I think if I could swap that out for a lighter transition shade than this shade right here, I think that would give this palette even more versatility. Now I do think this is a beautiful transition shade, but I think if you have an even lighter skin tone than me, I would say I have a solid light skin tone, but if you are more fair to porcelain, this might be even a little bit too dark for you. And generally speaking, if I have the choice between a coral and an orange, I'm usually going to go with a burnt orange over a coral. So I would keep this one and maybe change that one out to a light transition shade. I would also love to see this shade right here, the shade Lulu, swapped out. I do think it's a very beautiful shade, but I want to swatch these three shades for you guys. While there are some subtle differences in these, I think the fact they give you this lighter rose gold and this deeper kind of raspberry shade right here, I just don't feel like you really need this shade right here. And I would love to see a shimmery champagne. I'm a big fan of a shimmery champagne. I feel like I talk about it all the time. It's a shade that I use often because it goes with almost any look that you could ever create, and I certainly think it would go beautifully with the other shades inside this palette. They do give you this beautiful light shade right here, but this is very, very bright and white, and it definitely is a little bit more cool tone. So I'd love to see something that even has a little bit more warmth to it. It's maybe not quite as bright. I think that would give this palette so much versatility. So those are the changes I would love to see made to the Saharan palette. I'm gonna do a little Photoshop magic and insert the modified palette for you guys right here. I think if this palette looked like this, I think this would perhaps be one of my favorite Juvia's Place palettes, and that is saying something because Juvia's Place is one of my very favorite eyeshadow brands. The third really good palette that I would change to make it even better is the Tati Beauty Textured Neutrals palette. Now, this was one of my most anticipated eyeshadow palette releases of 2019. I was so excited to try out Tati's eyeshadow formula. I was quite confident that it would be super, super high quality, and I absolutely think that it is. That is something I was not disappointed by at all. The quality of her shadows are incredible. They are impeccable. And I have enjoyed playing with this palette. I did do a 7 looks video on this palette when it was first released. So I have used every shade inside here. Now, obviously her palette doesn't include this row of pressed glitters, and I'm sure knowing what I said about the ColourPop pressed glitter formula, you might assume that would be the number one thing that I would change. And while I don't use these glitters super often, I do think this is a better pressed glitter formula than the ColourPop one. It's a little bit less chunky, it's much more easy to apply and sort of sheer out. I also think Tati's idea behind this palette, the way that it's set up with the different textures, is really unique and different and fun, so I'm not going to actually make changes to the glitter row. If I was being super nitpicky, I would say leave 3 of the glitters and replace 3 of them maybe with some duochromes. But for this video, I would make changes to this row right here. This is her sequin row. Now, I do think the formula is really lovely, but what I found with this formula and the way that I typically like to use them, which is basically as a matte eyeshadow, they are quite similar in shade to the shades directly beneath them, so to the matte shades. And for that reason, I would love to see each of these shades basically a full shade lighter than the ones that you get in here. So I want to go through and swatch each of the matte and sequin shades for you guys so you can see how they compare to each other, and we'll talk about what I would change. So here's the matte black on the bottom and the sequin black on the top. And although you can see a little bit of that glitter reflect on here, you do see that the base color, the pigment that is behind the sequin, is pretty much the same color. I would have loved to see this same formula, but in a half a shade lighter, so more of a medium gray. I think that would have been so fun to include in here. It would give this role even more versatility, and I've actually been really into gray eyeshadows lately. It's kind of like a phase that I'm newly discovering and going through. But once again, I just feel like when you blend this sequin shade out, you basically are left with a matte black. And who needs two of the same color in an eyeshadow palette? Now let's move into the matte brown. So this is the Ritual shade. So here they are right here. Now this one actually does look a little bit lighter, but again, I found as I blended this shade out, it looked almost identical to the shade below it. I do love this matte brown. It's one of my favorite matte browns in my collection. It just blends so beautifully. But for the versatility of the palette, I would love to see this shade just a half a step lighter. I think it would have helped create a lot of variety in the looks that you could come up with in here. Now for the story column, this is the orange. Here those are swatched next to each other. So once again, you can see the base color is nearly identical. And I would have loved, especially in the story column, to see more of a peach rather than a true orange. I think that would open up so many possibilities for this palette, not just for that row right there, but in combination with some of the other shades. I love a good peach, and I would have loved to have seen that in this palette. So here's the Aura column swatched next to each other. Now this shade I feel like is deceivingly bright on camera. If you have very fair skin, again, lighter than my skin tone, this might be a little bit pigmented for you. So this is a very pink toned white, I would say. I even find on my skin in the winter time when I am more fair than I am right now, this is a little bit too dark for me to use as like a brow bone highlight. Now I am not someone that often highlights my brow bone because I have a lot of brow bone space. I don't need to draw attention to it, but if you do highlight your brow bone and you have fair skin, I think this shade might be a little bit dark for you perhaps. And what I would love to see in this sequin shade is a true almost ivory white. I have talked often on my channel about the fact that I think an eyeshadow palette that includes a matte white or near white gives a palette so much versatility. Now, I don't love matte white eyeshadow all over my lid, but when used underneath other shadows, maybe underneath some of the shimmers or the glitters, or even used in combination on a brush with another shade, it gives the palette so much versatility. And I would have really loved to see that right here. Last, the Poet Row. I love these shades. They are intensely pigmented. They are very berry toned. Here they are right there. They are both beautiful, but how much more beautiful and versatile would this palette be if this was more of like a dusty rose? I would have absolutely loved that. I think that shade, not just in combination with this column right here, but also with some of the lighter colors or the light browns or dark browns, could create some really beautiful eye looks. So those are the changes I would have made to this palette to keep with the whole theme that she was going for in here. Now that said, I do still love this palette. I think it's an amazing formula. I love using it. Every look that I've ever created with this thing has been incredible. Anytime I use it on camera, I always get questions about my eye look. So there's definitely nothing lacking in her formula, but for 24 shades, I just would have loved to see a little bit more variety, especially with this row right there. For the last two palettes, I'm going to mention them together because they are from the same brand, and they would be these two right here, the Natasha Denona Bronze and the Natasha Denona Love Palette. Now, let me start off by saying this. I'm a big fan of Natasha Denona's formula. I think it's way overpriced for sure, but I was very excited when she came out with her smaller palettes like these that are a little bit more affordable. They're definitely not affordable. They are still very expensive at $65 a pop. And when I tried out the Sunrise palette, I fell in love with that palette. I loved the color story. It was very unique. It was colorful, but it also gave you plenty of neutrals in there to build pretty much any look that you would want in that color family. And naturally, I was very excited when these palettes were released as well. But both of these palettes, while I do think they are beautiful, I feel like they are both missing some of the what I call building blocks of a good eyeshadow palette. And generally speaking, that will be something very light and brightening, something very neutral in the mid-tone range that I can use as a neutral transition shade, and then something very nice and rich and dark. So let's start off with the Bronze palette, her newest addition to these smaller 15 pan palettes. I did do a 7 looks video on this palette, and I have used it since. So I have used every shade in this palette, and I have a really good feel for each of these shades and what I really feel is missing from this one. Now, first off, you like warm bronzy eyeshadows. This is a beautiful palette. I will definitely not deny that. But when I was creating the 7 looks for this palette, I found that because so many of the shades in here, both matte and shimmer, are in that mid-tone range, a lot of the looks that I created ended up looking nearly identical to each other. And because there wasn't anything very bright in here, I just really couldn't change that up very much. I would love to see in this palette a very bright matte shade and a very brightening shimmery shade, like maybe a champagne or a very light gold. And the shades that I would cut from this palette would first off be this shade, True Copper. I do think this is a beautiful shade. There it is right there. But because you get so many warm bronzy shades in here, I don't feel like you need it. You could definitely live without it. I actually feel like it's quite similar to maybe a combination of these two colors right here. As you can see, I mean, there are some differences, but I don't feel like you need all three, and I would absolutely be willing to sacrifice this shade for maybe a shimmery champagne. As for the next shade, I would be willing to part with in exchange for a matte ivory. It would be this one right here, I decided, the shade Sundown. I do think this is a beautiful transition shade. It's a very nice, sort of soft orange creamsicle. I do think it's absolutely beautiful, but you get two other really wonderful transition shades in here as well, the shade Ridge and the shade Beach. Here they are right here, and I just don't feel like you need all three. So that is what I would change in this palette, and I truly believe if I had those two shades swapped out, this would be the palette of my dreams, because I do think it's beautiful. The shimmers in here are stunning. The textures in here are lovely. You get a really good amount of deep, rich outer corner shades, some good transitions, some beautiful lid shades. You just don't get enough brightness, in my opinion. Now, I know that the Natasha Denona palette, you technically can pop out the shades and swap things around, and I've briefly considered doing that, but it'd be hard to do that to one palette and then not make another palette worse. Let's have a look next at the Natasha Denona Love palette. As someone that likes pops of color but generally prefers neutrals, I should have known looking at this palette that there basically are no neutrals in here. You get a lot of pink, a lot of purple, and while I am not opposed to pink and purple, I typically only like pops of pink or purple in combination with some neutrals. And this palette desperately needs a couple of neutrals, in my opinion. The two things I would love to see changed in here is, number one, a matte neutral transition shade. So something that's more of like a peach or a tan. That is a color that when working with shades like this, I feel I absolutely need. I would also love to see a deep traditional brown in here. They do give you this shade Commitment, which is sort of a kind of brown toned purple. So this does work beautifully in the outer corner. But if you're wanting to maybe tone down some of that purple, I think a chocolatey brown would be a beautiful addition to this palette. So the two colors I would swap out for those two shades are, first off, this shade right here. This is the color Heart. As you can see, this is a beautiful kind of red raspberry shade. I do really like it. It is quite intense though, and considering the number of bright, bold pinks you already get inside here, and I know that these may not look that intense, but Natasha Denona's matte formula, there is a lot of pigment in it. It does not take a lot of product to get to a very bold place very quickly. So for me and my preferences, I would much rather have a matte transition shade right here than that bold raspberry shade. I could also live without this shade right here. This is the shade Intense. Now this shade, when you swatch it, it's deceivingly soft looking, but when you put this on your eyes, you get a very, very, very pink look. And as there are already plenty of matte pinks inside here, and I actually think I prefer more of the purples than the pink, so I could live without that matte shade in exchange for a traditional matte brown. So here is a look at what the Love palette would look like with those modifications. I absolutely think with those two simple changes made, I know I would love this palette a lot more than I do, and I would definitely use it a lot more than I do. I do want to add one more thought, especially about the Natasha Denona palettes. Now, when I am spending more on an eyeshadow palette, so when I'm spending $65 on a Natasha Denona eyeshadow palette, I have much higher expectations because I really want my palettes to be complete. I like when I can take it traveling with me and know that I'm not going to be missing a shade. So because these palettes are more expensive, I feel just a little bit more annoyed when they're missing a shade that I feel like I need, because I really hope to love these ones, especially because I do love Natasha Denona's formula. So those are the things I would change about those two palettes. I am certain if those replacements were made, I would be absolutely singing the praises of these palettes. And with that, you guys, that is it for the five good palettes in my collection that I think could be made even a little bit better. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Know that it was all in good fun. I recognize that a brand can't make a perfect palette for everyone because we're all different. We have different preferences, but hopefully this gave you guys some insight into what I look for in an eyeshadow palette and things that I don't really like very much. Thank you guys for joining me today. Thank you again to Jen and Andrea for collaborating with me. I cannot wait to see their videos. Be sure to check them out. I will link them down below. And one more reminder, if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, I hope that you will consider doing that. And that is it. I hope that you guys are doing well, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye. Siri, what's the definition of affinity?
Affinity means a spontaneous or natural liking or sympathy for someone or something.
That's right. I think I was thinking infinity, like Infinity War, and then I got thrown off. Hope you guys enjoyed this one, and of course, if you do, be sure to subscribe. Oh, I almost had it. For joining me today, big thank you to Andrea and Jen again for collaborating with me today. I said today like three times. You want me to play with you? What do you want to play? Wanna play dolls?
Yeah.
That's what I do. 7 hours a day now. Play dolls. Yeah. Can your brothers play dolls with you? No? You want me to play dolls? Yeah?